Jai Sitanam. Ramaya Ramabhadraya Ramachandraya Vedase Raghunathaya Nathaya Sitaya Pateye Namaha. Balakand, Chapter 33, Brahmadatta. In the previous chapter, sage Vishwamitra gave a history of his family. He talked about King Kusha, whose four sons, Kusanbha, Kusanabha, Adurta Rajas and Vasu, established the kingdoms Kaushambi, Mahodaya, Dharmaranya and Girivraja respectively, and the location where Rama and Lakshmana are at the moment, next to the river Shona, was actually the kingdom of the youngest son, that is King Vasu. And then Vishwamitra segues to the second brother, Kusanabha, and talks about Kusanabha's 100 very beautiful, graceful, and sweet daughters. One day, those 100 daughters went about in the garden, and Vayu, the lord of air, saw them and wanted to marry them. But those daughters, they had great spiritual prowess, and yet they say that they will not marry someone whom their father did not choose for them. Vayu is exceptionally angry and he distorts their limbs and they are now very misshapen. They go to their father, King Kusanabha, and he is obviously a little taken aback to see his beautiful daughters now looking so disfigured. In this chapter, we will see how those 100 daughters of King Kusanabha regained their beauty and their youth. Verse 1. Tasya tad vachanam shrutva kusanabhasya dhimata shirobhir charanau sprishtva kanya shatam abhashata. Thereupon, the 100 daughters of King Kusanabha laid their heads at his feet and spoke to him. Verse 2. Vayu sarvatmako rajan pradarshayitum icchati ashubham margam asthaya na dharmam pratyavekshate. Vayu, the pervader of all, would even compel us to his wishes, and forgetful of all sense of right and duty, had he recourse to evil ways. Verse 3. Pitramateya sma bhadram te svachande na vayam stitha pitaram no vrinishva tvam yadi no dasyate tava. We are under our reverend sire, we pleaded, and we're not our own masters. Ask thou our sire if he would give us to thee as wives. Thus we told the air god. But, verse 4. Tena papa anubandhena vachanam na pratichata evam bruvantiya sarva sma vayuna abhihata brisham. He would not listen to us, but with a heart bent on evil, made us what you see, even while we were earnestly pleading with him. So the girls tell their father the truth. Verse 5. Tasam tu vachanam shrutva raja parma dharmika prityuvacha mahateja kanya shatam anuttamam. Then the king, a rare model of patience and virtue, replied to his afflicted daughters in accents mild and grave. Verse 6. Kshantam kshamavatam putriya kartavyam sumahat kritam ekamatyam upagamya kulam cha avekshitam mama. Well have we done and gloriously. Forgiveness should characterize the life of everyone laying any claims to self-restraint and serenity. And you have borne patiently a deadly insult. I cannot enough praise your harmony of spirit and action, in that you have all acted alike and kept before your eyes the traditions of our race. So, King Kusanabha talks about Kshama. Kshama means forbearance, Kshama means forgiveness, and King Kusanabha says that forgiveness should characterize self-restraint and serenity. The king praises his daughters that all 100 of them have behaved exactly in the same way, and therefore by taking a united stand, they have protected the honor of the dynasty. So it is very clear that not only sons are supposed to keep up the honor, but even daughters too should do so. In Ayodhya Kand, when Bharata realizes that Kaikeyi was the mastermind behind the vanvas of his beloved Rama, Bharata says that Kaikeyi failed as a daughter and a mother, a stepmother, a co-wife, a queen, and literally every single role that a woman is supposed to have, she failed in all of those. And it's very interesting to see that he mentions that she failed to keep up the honor of her parents' family as well. And so Valmiki Ramayana teaches us that even girls are supposed to uphold the honor of their family. Obviously, we know that Mother Sita keeps up the honor of King Janaka's family very beautifully. And there are multiple instances like this. Verse 7. Alankaro hi nari nam kshamatu purushasya va dushkaram tatcha vai kshantam tridacheshu visheshataha yadrishihi vah kshama putriya sarvasam avisheshataha. Forgiveness is the brightest jewel in the crown of a woman. Nay, for that matter, man as well. Hard task for a girl to brave a man's wiles. Harder to have a giant strength and not use it like a giant in the face of deadly insult. Harder still not to burn one's wings at the baleful fires of celestial beauty. Harder still to keep back our thunderbolts when we have the right to launch them against the mighty gods and the chance. And lo, hardest of all, wonder of wonders, the wayward hearts of 100 maidens beating all one stroke and acting in perfect unison. This is indeed laudable. Verse 8. Kshama danam kshama satyam kshama yajna cha putrikah kshama yashah kshama dharma kshamayam vishtitam jagat. Endowed with forgiveness, a man need not go to seek for any other virtue, charity, truth, sacrifice, fame, or righteousness, for forgiveness rules the world and holds it up. King Kusanabha says that kshama is danam, that means charity. Kshama is satyam, that means truth. Kshama is yajna, that means sacrifice. And kshama is yashaha, that means fame. And kshama is dharma, that means righteousness. And kshamayam vishtitam jagat, forgiveness rules the world and holds it up. So this is a very important aspect mentioned in Valmiki Ramayana. In the first couple of chapters of Ayodhya Kand, where the description of Rama the prince is given in very great detail, one of the qualities that is mentioned there is that Rama does not even remember the other person's offenses. And Rama is very quick to forgive. And if a slight service is done to him, he expands it to such a great degree. He makes such a big ado of even the slightest service that is done to him. And if there are any offenses, he does not even remember them. And this is Rama's forgiveness. In Bhagavad Gita, 16th chapter, verses 1 to 3, Lord Krishna explains the various qualities of a divine person. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Abhayam Sattva Sanshuddhir Jnana Yoga Vyavastitaha Danam Damascha Yajnascha Svadhyaya Stapa Arjavam Ahimsa Satya Akrodhas Tyaga Shantir Apaishunam Daya Bhuteshav Aloluptvam Mardavam Khrir Achapalam Tejah Kshama Dhritir Saucham Adraho Nati Manita Bhavanti Sampadam Daivim Abhijatasya Bharata. The Supreme Personality of God had said, fearlessness, purification of one's existence, cultivation of spiritual knowledge, charity, self-control, performance of sacrifice, study of the Vedas, austerity, simplicity, non-violence, truthfulness, freedom from anger, renunciation, tranquility, aversion to fault-finding, compassion for all living entities, freedom from covetousness, gentleness, modesty, steady determination, vigor, forgiveness, fortitude, cleanliness, and freedom from envy and from the passion for honor. These transcendental qualities, O son of Bharata, belong to godly men endowed with divine nature. So Kshama is one of these qualities, and Kshama is a godly divine nature. Now, what should we do with this information? In Srimad Bhagavatam 12.2.1, Sri Shukadev Goswami says, Sri Shuka Uvacha, Tatas Chanu Dinam Dharma Satyam Shaucham Kshama Daya Kalena Balina Rajan Nangshyati Ayur Balam Smritihi. Shukadeva Goswami said, then, O King, religion, truthfulness, cleanliness, tolerance, mercy, duration of life, physical strength and memory will all diminish day by day because of the powerful influence of the age of Kali. So, in the purport, since we are interested in learning about Kshama, the detailed explanation of Kshama is given as follows. Kshama, tolerance or forgiveness, is diminishing as well because there is no practical method by which people can purify themselves and thus become free of envy. Unless one is purified by chanting the holy names of the Lord in an authorized program of spiritual improvement, the mind will be overwhelmed by anger, envy, and all sorts of small-mindedness. Thus, daya or mercy is also decreasing. All living beings are eternally connected by their common participation in the divine existence of God. When this existential oneness is obscured through atheism and agnosticism, people are not inclined to be merciful to one another. They cannot recognize their self-interest in promoting the welfare of other living beings. In fact, people are no longer even merciful to themselves. They systematically destroy themselves through liquor, drugs, tobacco, meat eating, promiscuity, and whatever other cheap gratificatory processes are available to them. So by continuously chanting, we can get this forgiveness quality in us. And King Kusanabha says that forgiveness is equivalent to charity, truth, sacrifice, fame, and righteousness. Verses 9 and 10. Visrijya kanyah kakutsta raja tridasha vikrama mantragnyo mantra yamasa pradanam zahamantribihi. Deshakale chakartavyam sadrishe pratipadanam. Mightier than the very gods, yet he sent them away and consulted with his wise ministers as to the marriage of his daughters, the time, the place, and the parties. Verse 11. Etasmin eva kale tu chuli nama mahajutihi urdhva retah shubacharo brahman tapa upagamat. It was about that time a great sage, Culi by name, practiced the Brahmatapas with pure life and chaste vows. Verse 12. Tapasyantam rishim tatra gandharvi paryupasate somada nama bhadram te urmila atane atada. A Gandharvi, Somada by name, the daughter of Urmila, attended upon him devotedly with restrained senses and righteous heart. Verse 13. Sa chitam pranata bhutva shushrushana parayana uvasakale dharmishta tasya tushto abhavat guruhu. Somada rendered her services with devotion and humility. There she lived a religious life. In the meantime, her spiritual guru was satisfied with her services. Verse 14. Sachitam kala yogena provacha raghunandana paritushto asmi bhadramte kim karomi tava priyam. Gratified with her service, the Holy One saw into the record of time and spoke, Fair lady, well hast thou served me and won my favor. Is there anything I can do for thee? Verse 15. Parituṣṭam munim jñātvā gandharvi madhurasvaram uvāca parama prīta vākyajñā vākyakovidam. She marked that he was in a mood to give, and in sweet words and apt did she pray to the Blessed One, who was no mean speaker himself. Verse 16. Lakshmiya samudito brahmya brahma bhuto mahatapaha brahmena tapasa yuktam putram ichhami dharmikam. Lord, I make no difference between Thee and the Supreme Brahma. So great Thy tapas and so mighty the Brahmic splendor that crowns Thee. I would even have a son endowed with Brahma tapas. Verse 17. Apati cha asmi bhadram te bharya cha asmi na kasya chit brahmena upagataya cha datum arhasi mesutam. No husband do I take, nor does any claim me as his wife. Give me a son, in that I approach thee according to the Brahma mode of marriage. Verse 18. Tasya prasanna brahma rishir dada brahman anuttamam brahmadatta iti khyatam manasam chulina sutam. Pleased with her purity of heart and nobility of purpose, Culi gave her a mind-born son named Brahmadatta. Verse 19. Saraja Brahmadatta tu purim adhyavasattada kampilyam pareya lakshmiya devarajo yatha divam. Kampilya made he his capital and held sway there as splendidly as Indra over his heavenly realm. Verse 20. Sabuddhim kritavan raja kushanabha sudharmika brahmadattaya kakutsta datum kanya shatam tada. And Kusanbha made up his mind to bestow his 100 daughters to Brahmadatta. Verse 21. Tam ahuya mahateja brahmadatta mahipati dadau kanya shatam raja supritena antaratmana. Respectfully did he invite him to his city and pray him to accept his girls in marriage. Verse 22. Yata kramam tatah panim jagraha raghunandana brahmadatto mahipala tasam devapatir yatha. O son of Raghu, that king Brahmadatta, resembling Indra, received the hands of those maidens in due order. Verse 23. Sprishta matre tatha pano vikupja vigata jvara yukta paramaya lakshmiya babhau kanya shatam tada. And lo, the moment Brahmadatta took them by the hand, their deformity and grief dropped away from them like a dark cloak, and they shone, if possible, with greater loveliness and grace than ever. Verse 24. Sadrishtva vayuna mukta kushnabho mahipati babhuva paramo prito harsham lebhe punah punah. The father's heart knew no bounds to his joy to see them freed from the evil spell cast upon them by Vayu. Kusanbha was very happy to look at them again and again. Verse 25. Krita udvaham tu rajanam brahmadattam mahipati sadaram preshayamasa sa upadhyaya ganam tada. Later on, Kusanbha sent them away with their husband to his capital, with splendor becoming their rank and his sense of joy. Verse 26. Somada api sutam drishtva putrasya sadrisham kriyam yatha nyayam cha gandharvi snushahta pratyanandata sprishtva sprishtva cha tah kanya Kusanabham prashasya cha. Somada, the fond mother, rejoiced most at the glorious choice her son did make. She could not fondle her daughters-in-law enough, nor praise their noble father. So this is how the 100 daughters of King Kusanbha regained their beauty. In the next chapter, sage Vishwamitra continues with the details of his ancestry. Mangalam Kushalendraya Mahaniya Gunavdeya Chakravarti Dhanurajaya Sarva Bhaumaya Mangalam Jai Sitaram.